Hey, yo. You don't have to love me. You don't even have to like me. But you will respect me. You know why? 'Cause I'm a boss.
I was gonna make this into a post, but it was just too much, and I knew people was gonna go ahead and write me these big fat paragraphs, and I did not feel like dealing with big fat paragraphs, so I decided to go live. So earlier, I'm at the gas station, and this guy, he gets out his car, and he called his girlfriend a bitch. So he was like, such, 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 get back in the effing car, bitch. So I was like, oh, Lordy, no, no, he did not. No, he didn't. So the guy who owned the store, I guess he's familiar with them too. So he come out the store and he like, you can't be talking to her like that, like that. That's your queen. That's your lady. This is in the third. So I paid for my gas and he was like, I seen you make a face when I said that. And I was like, yeah, I kind of made a face because he grown and she grown. He gonna talk to her however he want to, and she's gonna accept the treatment that he gives to her. Now, this is where I feel like a conflict comes into place. I feel like, yeah, he should have checked him, because I feel like nowadays not too many men hold other men accountable for their actions, which, you know, I salute him for that. But then I also felt like as a woman, I should have stepped up and said something to the young lady. But at what point do us as women, at what point do we have enough self-respect for ourselves to not tolerate that? And I honestly feel like if she had self-love and self-respect for herself, she would have never allowed a man to talk to her like that. And that's just that on that. And this is my new thing. When we do our lives, we're gonna burn an incense. We're gonna set the mood. But no, I just really feel like if she had respect for herself, when women have a certain level of respect for themselves and they hold themselves to a certain standard, men know how they need to come. They know they need to come correct, and they know that they can't talk to her in any crazy form. So I would like for y'all to, you know, join my little conversation, because I don't want to talk to myself. But thank you, Nana. Thank you, boo. But yes, I just feel like us as women, if we respect ourselves, these men, they can't get away with as much stuff as they've been getting away with treating us crazy. And I honestly feel like some women don't know how to respect themselves or how to love themselves, because they may come from an environment where their mom put up with certain treatment, or their aunt put up with certain treatment, or they have girlfriends that's putting up with similar situations as them. So everything around them is disrespect. Every woman in their life is being disrespected. All of the men, they're disrespecting. And I also feel like it's not just on the women. I feel like it's on the men as well. If these men were raised in a certain way, that they know you do not treat women this way. A woman, we birth earth. You would not be here without a woman. I don't care if your mom was an alcoholic, if she beat you or whatever. You need to respect women. You have to respect women. But ultimately, what I'm trying to say is I feel like these men need to have better examples of men in their lives who truly know how to love a woman and really know how to respect women. But men can't respect something that the woman does not respect herself, if that makes sense. Like, if we don't respect ourselves and we don't hold ourselves to a higher standard, we really cannot expect for a man to respect us. Is it wrong for them to disrespect us? Absolutely. But if we don't take care of ourselves, if we look down on ourselves, we talk badly about ourselves, we don't hold our head up high, we don't make ourselves our number one priority. And that's where a lot of women, in my opinion, that's my opinion, I think that's where we go wrong. A lot of us as women, we take care of our husband, we take care of our boyfriends, we take care of our kids, we take care of our home, we take care of, you know, a lot of my friends, we all work in some type of hospitality. You know, we're serving somebody in some type of way. So we're taking care of, like at me, I'm a nurse. I'm taking care of my residents. You know, some people take care of their customers and then they put themselves at the very freaking end. And then they wonder why they don't have much left over for themselves. And we're burnt out. We're burnt out because we should have been first. We should have been first in line. We can't take care of anyone if we don't take care of ourselves. And that, to me, that is one of the number one things when it comes to self-care and self-love. You cannot fully love yourself if you put everybody before you. It's not bad to be selfish. It's not bad. It is honestly a good thing to be selfish in a sense. You have to put self first because you can't pour from an empty cup. You can't. You're going to have this cup, this juice. Y'all who know me know I don't drink. But this juice. But let's say we got this juice. Okay, I'm going to give him some juice. I'm going to give her some juice. I'm going to give them some juice. I'm going to give her some juice. And then when I come to take me a little sip, all I got left is this. That's not going to quench my thirst. I can't do anything for anybody if I'm thirsty. I'm empty. My cup is empty. I can't do anything with the empty cup. So we have to take care of ourselves first. And I feel like once we set that standard as women to put ourselves first, to love ourselves, these men, they know, oh, baby, I have to come with it if I want to mess with her. She don't play. She got her shit together. She's beautiful. She has self-respect. She's gentle. They'll know that they have to come with it. And some of these men treat us certain ways because of the way that we treat ourselves. They know they can get away with it. They know that we don't hold ourselves to a certain standard. So why do they have to treat you any higher? That's like you treat yourself like you are 50 cent, but you expect somebody to treat you like you worth a dollar. In what world? In what world? You have to treat yourself like you are a full dollar every single day when you walk out the house. And it is so crazy because I started watching like a lot of these videos on YouTube of women who teach you how to value yourself and put yourself first. And it's crazy because I used to go out the house with a regular little raggedy little scraggly ponytail. I wouldn't do my makeup. I wouldn't take the extra time. I do my own nails. I do my own feet. I wouldn't take the time and do any of that. When I actually started like really enjoying that and not doing it just to do it. But when I really started enjoying it, I see different treatment. People run the whole doors for me. When I go into stores, it could be a woman right next to me. I get serviced first. It's literally... you exude it. You exude that you deserve the best, that you deserve the best treatment. People treat you better when you treat yourself better. So that's pretty much the word I had. I don't know if anybody else had any commentary for this. But that's pretty much what I had to say is we have to love ourselves first. And it's okay if you don't know how to love yourself. It's okay. It's okay. I don't care if you're 20. I don't care if you're 30. I don't care if you're 40. I don't care if you're 50. If you don't know how to love yourself, it's okay. It's okay. But what you need to learn and what you need to do is get a piece of paper and write down two lists. One list of things that you don't want in life. Things you don't want. You know what you don't want. You know what you don't want. And then on that other piece of paper is things that you want and you demand out of life. And every day that you wake up, you need to remind yourself to never accept anything on that don't list. Never accept anything on that don't list, whether it's a job, whether it's a car, a home, a man, treatment, whatever. I don't care. A vacation. If it's something that you don't want, don't accept nothing on that list. And if you accept something that's on that list of the don'ts, that's on you. You decided to go against your own don't list. And everything that's on the do list, those are things that you work towards every day. every day. And if it's a big goal, you need to make small little goals to get to that. It's hard working on ourselves. And sometimes it's ugly. Sometimes it's ugly putting that mirror up to ourselves and really seeing the damage that we have inside. Sometimes it's ugly really seeing who we really are. Like, it's scary. It's scary holding that mirror up to yourself. But it is the only way that you're going to get treated a certain way that you want to be treated. You have to put that mirror up to yourself. You have to know who you are in order to know where you're going. You can't go anywhere. You can't if you don't know who you are. And if you don't know who you are, you can't love yourself. And my mom raised me in a way of, you can't love another human being. You can't love yourself until you learn to love God. Whether your God is Jesus, Buddha, Jehovah, whoever it is that you pray to at night or when you're going through things, you have to love that first. You have to love that first. And until you learn to love your God, you cannot learn to love yourself. And if you do not learn to love yourself, you cannot learn to love another human being. How can you love somebody when you don't even love yourself? Ladies, I know I'm not talking to myself out there. Like, I can't be like, you have to seriously learn to love yourself. And, you know, you might need to meditate and take some time away. Hell, you might need to be single for some time. When you really on your journey, you lose friends, you lose men, you might be at a job that you've been at for 20 years and you will walk away from that job, I'm telling you, because it disturbs everything in your body. One of the reasons why I do travel nursing is because I can't stay at jobs long. I can't. I don't really mesh with a lot of people at jobs, really. So when I do click with somebody, it's something special in them. I don't like being in toxic situations. When you really start to like really dig and really learn to love yourself and get to know yourself, everything around you, it start popping out. You know, it just start popping out. You've been praying. Please show me who is not for me. It will be right there in your face. And it won't hurt you to let it go. It seriously will not hurt you to let it go. And when you let it go, those demons might start clawing, trying to get their way back in. But it won't bother you. It won't bother you. Instead, you can also have a fight with yourself. Yeah, exactly. Like, say your choice determines your fate. It's from the second choice. It's from the devil. Seriously. Yeah, you can be in a fight with yourself. I was in a fight with myself for many years. I was angry. When I say angry, I mean angry. It could have been the smallest thing. I'm angry. I don't even know why I'm angry. I'm up. I'm angry. Something good happened. I'm angry. Something good happened for somebody else around me. I'm angry. Like, why am I so angry? And you realize you don't love yourself. You don't love yourself. That's why you're angry. That's why you're angry. And once you really learn to love yourself, you realize that what's for you is for you and what's for them is for them. And you learn, you naturally become happy for your accomplishments. You become happy for other people's accomplishments. But I just really hate the society that we are in where a lot of us think that we have to be with somebody to make us happy. Or you'd be like, he don't make me happy. She don't make me happy. Baby, do you make you happy? Do you make you happy? Like, that's the question. Do you make you happy? If you don't make yourself happy, you got some work to do. And it's okay. It might be a long road, but it's gonna be a good road. You're gonna be happy when you get there. I'm telling you, you're gonna be happy when you get to where you wanna be and you happy with yourself and you can fully fulfill yourself. You can't go into a partnership and you think that it's 50-50. No, baby, it's not. You got to come complete and they have to come complete. How I look at love, you got to look at it as two people going snorkeling, right? When you go snorkeling, you go underwater with these oxygen tanks. That's like going snorkeling with two people with one oxygen tank. You're going to be down there dying, just dying, asking your buddy, could I have some oxygen? I'm whole again. But then once they go away with their oxygen tank, you don't have any oxygen. You need their oxygen tank. You do not want to rely on somebody else's oxygen tank to make yourself full, to make yourself okay. You need to come and bring your own oxygen tank. And what's your oxygen tank? Your oxygen tank is your love for yourself. You seriously cannot go snorkeling with one oxygen tank and two people. You need two oxygen tanks. So those two oxygen tanks represent that love for yourself. So that's like going back to way back where I started from at the beginning of life. That girl, she don't have an oxygen tank. That man, he didn't have an oxygen tank. Neither one of them had one. They both just down there at the bottom of the sea, just drowning, just, you know, drowning. And it's not okay, but it's okay. That's their journey for them to get through. And it's for me to tell my ladies out there, do not go into anything without an oxygen tank. You have to love yourself. Like, you gotta love yourself. But that's all I have. And I really enjoyed this, you know. And those who see this smoke, no, I don't smoke. We burning incense over here. So every time I go live and it's like a word, we're gonna burn incense to set the mood. And that's what this is. And this is not alcohol. This is like berry pomegranate juice. I don't drink, so... I want to thank everybody for joining my live, and I think I'm gonna come back tomorrow. We're gonna come back with another word. Bye.